A rigid insulated tank that is initially evacuated is connected through a valve to a supply line that carries steam at 4.5 megapascals. Now the valve is opened and steam is allowed to flow into the tank until the pressure reaches 4.5 megapascals, at which point the valve is closed. If the final temperature of the steam in the tank is 600 Celsius, determine the temperature of the steam in the supply line and the flow work per unit mass of the steam. As usual, pause here and try solving this yourself before watching the solution. This is the second example for the Transient Systems main lecture. The link to that 9-minute lecture and all the other lectures of the Thermo course are found in the description below. This is an easy one. The energy conservation reduces to mass coming in times its specific enthalpy for the change in energy, the mass at the end times its specific internal energy for the final energy, and zero for the initial energy. And since the mass that went in is the final mass, since there was no initial mass, masses cancel out, and we have that the specific enthalpy coming in is equal to the specific internal energy at the end inside the tank. Since what we have is the temperature and pressure inside the tank, we use these two values to get the specific internal energy U. We go to the superheated tables for water, since we were told it was steam, and look up 4.5 megapascals and 600 degrees Celsius. We write down the specific internal energy value. Since this is equal to the specific enthalpy of the steam coming in, which is the steam in the supply line, we can find the temperature of the line with its pressure and specific enthalpy. We go to the same table for 4.5 megapascals, and since our value for the specific enthalpy is between 3205 and 3324, we interpolate between 400 and 450 degrees Celsius to find that the temperature of the line is 429.8 degrees Celsius. The flow work per unit mass would just be the difference between the specific enthalpy and the specific internal energy of the line. So we do the same interpolation for the internal energy at 430 degrees Celsius to obtain UN. We subtract these values and obtain the flow work. If you want to check out other examples for transient or unsteady flow systems, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below. You'll also find the links to the other lectures of the Thermo course as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!